Itron is proud to continue moving the gas distribution network from a one-way gas delivery mechanism to an interactive energy network that can deliver gas more safely and efficiently. Itron is enhancing the Intelis 250 gas meter, including optional pressure sensing, and introducing the Intelis 425 gas meter, which always includes pressure sensing. Intelis is an ultrasonic gas meter designed to enhance safety and operational efficiency for customers by embedding communications and safety shutoff in compact smart gas meters. Intelis 250 and 425 gas meters are produced in Itron's North American Center of Excellence production facility located in Oconee, South Carolina. At only 4.35 pounds, the Intelis 250 gas meter is the lightest and most compact residential meter with an improved capacity of 300 cubic feet per hour rating. The hub center-to-center distance is 6 inches, matching standard residential diaphragm meter sets. In addition, the hubs are the same as today's diaphragm meters, therefore no changes are required for field retrofits, and meter changeouts may be easily accomplished. The Intelis 425 gas meter is a compact ANSI 500 class meter, with an impressive capacity of 600 cubic feet per hour at a half-inch water column. Available with both an 8.25 and 6-inch hub center-to-center distance for easy field retrofits. As with every gas module Itron has ever brought to the market, Intelis has the most stringent Underwriters Laboratories rating of Class 1, Division 1. Intelis was designed with a traditional die-cast aluminum case and powder coat finish to withstand outdoor elements. Itron continues its long-standing tradition of superb battery life performance. The meter has a 20-year battery life, including the meter, communications, and valve. The common platform index with pressure sensing is used on both the Intelis 425 and the 250 meter if pressure sensing is required. For an Intelis 250 meter without pressure sensing, a pressure sensor is not placed on the printed circuit board assembly. This pressure sensor measures atmospheric pressure. The Intelis gas meters are comprised of an inlet tube, dust trap and filter, ultrasonic measuring unit, shutoff valve, and outlet tube. The internal design of the Intelis 250 gas meter makes it independent from any piping influences before and after the meter. The gas flows in through the inlet tube and down through the dust trap. Here, a brush filter captures dust particles. The gas is directed through the two inlet flow channels and through the brush filter in the dust trap. Upon exiting the dust trap, the gas flows through the ultrasonic measuring unit with improved capacity. Intelis uses time-of-flight measurement principle utilizing two ultrasonic transducers. A signal is sent from the upstream transducer to the downstream transducer and then in reverse. The time to go from upstream to downstream, indicated by the purple arrows, is faster than the reverse, shown in green. The time difference between both directions is used to determine volume. The shutoff valve is located on the outlet side of the meter. When the valve is open, it is at an angle. This reduces turbulence when gas is flowing. This higher capacity Intelis 425 gas meter is uniquely designed. The 425 meter and the 250 meter use the same UMU and valve. When a 250 meter is purchased without pressure sensing, The pressure sensor is not placed on the index or valve circuit board. This pressure sensor on the valve circuit board measures the absolute pressure. The shape of the inlet tube diffuses the gas flow, including any particles, away from the UMU. As the gas flows, equal amounts pass through the UMU and the flow diverter, resulting in only 50% of potential harmful particles entering the UMU. In addition, the larger casting of the 425 allows more particles to settle at the bottom of the meter due to gravity. Because of these design features, a brush filter is not required in the Intelis 425 gas meter. Both Intelis 250 and 425 use time-of-flight measurement principle, utilizing two ultrasonic transducers. A signal is sent from the upstream transducer to the downstream transducer, and then in reverse. The shutoff valve is located on the outlet side of the meter. When the valve is open, it is at an angle. This reduces turbulence when gas is flowing. This use case demonstrates how the valve will automatically shut off gas flow once it is above the high flow threshold. For example, a homeowner is changing out a defective hot water heater. Prior to removal, gas is flowing at a typical rate through the meter. The valve is open. The homeowner disconnects the line without turning off the gas, and the gas line is left open. The meter will automatically close the valve, shutting off gas flow once a pre-programmed limit is reached, much like an excess flow valve in the meter. An alarm is triggered as soon as this threshold is reached. This potentially alleviates a dangerous situation, or even explosion, resulting from an open fuel line inside a home. In network mode, this alarm will be sent to the head end along with a confirmation message of valve closure. In mobile mode, the same alarm and valve closure message will be sent. The homeowner is likely to call the utility to report a gas outage before the alarm is picked up by the mobile collector. The utility should follow their standard operating procedure, such as dispatching a technician to the site to safely inspect the situation. This use case demonstrates how the pressure sensing capability allows for autonomous valve shutoff when high pressure is detected. Utilizing the pressure sensors on the valve, and index circuit boards. The meter calculates the gauge pressure of the gas flowing through the meter. The meter will automatically close the valve, shutting off gas flow once a utility configurable high pressure limit is reached. Additionally, in network mode, as soon as a high pressure or low pressure threshold is reached, an alarm is sent to the head end. This use case demonstrates how a utility can remotely shut off the gas. A customer smells gas inside the home due to a small leak. The customer contacts the utility, explaining the gas smell. Utilizing the network, the utility operator remotely sends a command to shut the valve, stopping the flow of gas. The utility should follow their standard operating procedure, such as dispatching a technician to the site to perform an inspection. Knowing that the gas flow has already been shut off creates a safer situation for utility workers, homeowners, and the community at large. Join us in creating a more resourceful world.